I mean, obviously, it was the toughest fight of his career. You know, it wasn't the cleanest of victories. You know, I thought he could, I expected him to do it a little bit in a cleaner fashion. But it just also just proves how bad Sean Porter wanted the victory today. We know Sean's a dog. I wasn't happy with Sean's last performance. I wasn't even happy with Errol's last performance. But to see this performance, they satisfied the world of boxing, and it was great.
Now, they talk about Danny Garcia against Errol Spence. What do you think?
You know, I like the matchup because, once again, it's another style that we haven't seen Errol face. And if anything that we can learn from tonight, I mean, real fight fans know this, but tonight was another proof that styles makes fights. It was not a dominant performance. Sean Porter was in the fight. He was forcing tons of action. Errol's just a tremendous champion. He had the grit. He's got composure. He was throwing body shots constantly throughout the fight. He landed that knockdown. But yeah, man, him versus Danny, it's just a fight we haven't seen. Danny throws more power than Sean Porter, and Danny Garcia is a counterpuncher. It's just something we haven't seen Spence up against. It would be a great fight.
Last thing, Caleb Plant, David Benavidez. What's your take on that one?
I mean, that's the best matchup in that whole weight division.
Okay, sorry.
And that whole division, that's the best matchup. You know, I'm okay with Benavidez taking his mandatory and just, you know, embracing the fact that he's champion, holding it down, beating a mandatory, and being champion again. And then in the future, right after that, going into a unification bout with Caleb Plant, I think is just the biggest thing in that division.
Next, Keith Thurman, obviously getting the hand better. And then what?
And then, you know, whatever doors open up for me in 2020, I want the Manny Pacquiao rematch. That's all I want.
I think this is your vehicle we can win.
That's all I want is the Manny Pacquiao rematch. I'm walking. I'm not going.
Okay, I hope you get it.
But outside of that, if I don't get that, then we're going to do what we did this year. Open up the year with a good, nice get-back fight. And then from there, one of the best. I'll make the best fight I possibly can at the end of 2020. If I don't get to open my first fight with Manny Pacquiao. So we'll just see, man. And when I say the best fight of 2020, the biggest fight, that means you really know that it might be me and Spence sometime, you know. What? After the summer, you're talking, I mean, talking about like late next year, because I'm not going to be in the ring till May or June, and then maybe about 5 months after that, I want a bigger fight.
You have common opponents, Bondu, Porter. I'm trying to think if there's anyone else you fought.
So this is the funny part. He outperformed me with Bundu by getting the knockout. But there's questions on whether or not I could have stopped Bundu in the first round if I really jumped on him, right? So, but from what I did and what he did, he beat Bundu better than I beat Bundu. But can we say he beat Porter better than I beat Porter? Come on, man. This your boy Keith One Time Thurman.
Doing a great job behind the mic, in the ring, everywhere, man. You're doing a great job.
This is Keith Thurman reporting.
There you have it. One of the best ever. Make sure to follow him. Please do the boy that comments back reporting.